Thank you very much, Zina. Good day to gentlemen at the high table. Just for you, Coach Daan, Joe Schmidt spoke to the media this morning and he mentioned that this allowed try, James Lowe try, which he said was a controversial call and that the Springboks tend to get lucky from those calls. Do you think maybe my games out of the two games?
Well, there's been a thing about that, but I can tell you one thing. We at the moment we're just trying to adapt new rules. I mean, the referees. Are you referring to the referees' calls?
Yes, so as I said again, Joe Schmidt spoke to the media about James Lowe try and South Africa tend to get with those controversial calls, as he said, Joe Schmidt this morning.
Sorry, sometimes I suppose some calls in some games go for you and some go against you, but I mean, I'm not gonna comment on what he said, and if we have sometimes a lot of calls in our favor, I'm not gonna comment on that. I suppose what we've been doing with at the moment is just to try to adapt as soon as possible to the new rules of the game, and we must adapt the way the ref's handling it. So yeah.
Again.
Thanks, Zeno. Morning, guys, or evening for you guys. Coach Don, just a question for you. Throughout the ages, throughout the years, and I'm sure it was the same even when you were playing, there's always an expectation that the Springbok scrum is going to be better than Australia's scrum. But through the years, we've discovered that they've got all sorts of ways of, I guess, nullifying the perceived advantage at scrum time. Can you just talk to us from a scrum coach's perspective about the challenges of taking on the Australian scrum?
Yeah, I would say every team has got a lot of strengths, and I suppose that is definitely one of our strengths. But yes, they always get a way to manage us and to handle us. And maybe sometimes they're good, sometimes they're not so good, but I'm not going to refer where they're good. I can tell you 100% they 100% in the last three games they had a great outcome, and in that outcome I mean they're much more stable scrum than they used to be in the past. But yeah, so are we. We are already working on a lot of new stuff that we actually want to implement as well. So we little by little we're getting there, and we'll see on Saturday how it goes and if we're going forward or not.
Steven?
Saying as much.
Steven? Okay, we can't hear you, Steven. Morgan?
Hi,
Steven?
hi, thanks, Z. It's hi, Grant, Don, Erchim. Erchim, if I can just go to you quickly. You know, it's not often that the Springboks will play the world's second-ranked team, one of the top teams before the Rugby Championship, like you guys did against Ireland. How much did they prepare you for this championship? Because normally we'll see one versus two in the championship itself.
Yeah, I don't think we could have been prepared any better, you know, facing Ireland those two games. And yeah, we've certainly learned a lot within those two games, and yeah, we will hopefully learn, well, we have learned from it, and we'll carry that into the championship.
Thanks, sir.
Cole?
Coach Don, thank you for the opportunity and the other two gentlemen. Just one question. If we look at the Currie Cup games, the 80 to 100 points get scored per game these days. And you said you're working on new things for the scrums. Is the scrum becoming less important in Springbok rugby? Or yeah, how do you treat it with the new faster game plan that the guys are playing?
No, we actually just continue what we've been doing in the past. and we still say try to stay focused on what's working for us and what's not working for us, and obviously on the stuff that's not working for us, we need to get better at that. And like I said a bit earlier, we always must adapt to the way that the referee is handling the game as well. The quicker the possible way. So yeah, I think it's still part of our game, and like in the Curry Cup, I think it's still part of our mentality in South Africa. Like all the teams, if you have a dominant scrum, it helps you. It gives you a nice platform to start the game off or to play off. So yeah, I don't think it's something that's being worked out by that. I think it's actually only one rule that actually changed, and that's you can't take from a free kick in your own 22 a scrum. That's the only thing that actually changed so far. Obviously, sometimes you get the advantage in a game if there's a lot of scrums, and you can put a lot of pressure on a position, and obviously you need to be able to have a proper platform. But it comes down to the hard work that you're trying to do, and we hopefully the scrum will stay part of the game for a long time.
Can you so?
Yeah, I did.
Thank you very much, Dina. Good evening, gentlemen. I hope all is well. Coach Dan, this particular game, Australia has always been a tricky one for South Africa over the past 18, 29 years, to be honest. But in this particular context, how important is it in terms of the evolution of the BOC team and its attacking game in particular?
Listen, there's a lot of players that actually just got into with us, a lot of young guys. That we little by little getting into the group, because we realize as well, looking forward, although we're not looking too far forward to 2027, but at the moment we try to stay focused on the very next game, and that's what we're trying to do. If I can say, we work on that. We're trying to get them in the system as quick as possible, and let them be. Obviously part of our culture, and I think little by little they're starting to get there. Does that understand does it answer your question?
Yeah, partially it does.
Steven? Steven, your line is really bad. Do you want to try again? Okay, Leighton.
Hi Z. Hi Dan. Hi RG. Hi Grant. Net Stevens' a vraag is in the chat, so I'll just ask him, Coach Dan, this. He wants your thoughts on the 30-second clock law at the scrums, and whether it is tough to adapt or not.
Well, it's not tough to adapt because, like always, last week we got to I think 16 live scrums in 20 minutes. So we're more or less there what we like to achieve. And I think there's a little bit less scrums in a game normally. But it's not a new thing for us. Like always in the past, I've said it, we like to try to get our scrum sessions tougher than the games, which is not always the case. We're trying to get there as close as possible. But for us, setting it up in 30 seconds, it's normal. We measured ourselves this week, and I think we got to the point where we actually right on par where we want to be, so it's not really a change for us. If you want to get some good scrums, obviously you must train them well, and in that space of time we always try to have as much as possible to get them ready for the scrum.
And then just my question, please, just looking at New Zealand's playing Argentina twice now, how important will it be for you guys to get to a good start in both these tests, just to not let New Zealand jump too far ahead in terms of points on that rugby championship log, so that you don't come by the last four games have to chase them?
Yeah, well, how can I say, whether they're playing against Argentina doesn't matter for us. We only focus on our game coming up. So we're not really thinking ahead of catching up and getting bonus points and stuff like that, which was probably the case last year where we had to win with a certain margin of points. We don't think further than the game of Saturday, and we realize it's quite important for us to win them and do well and to start well.
Ben?
Thanks, Ina. Achia, just for you, can you just talk to us about the differences in terms of playing Ireland for the last couple of weeks, and what are the differences now coming up against a team like Australia?
Yeah, I think playing Ireland prepared us very well, you know, because I think they've also got a lot of systems and stuff set up from being coached by Joe Schmidt as well. And so, yeah, there will certainly be some differences, you know, with a certain style of play that Australia bring and the players they have. But I think in a lot of ways, there'll be similarities come set piece wise and things like that. So, yeah, we're looking forward to facing that challenge as well.
Nathan?
Thank you again, Zina. Coach Dawn, what do you make of the Australian side? They come in the rugby champs unbeaten this year with changes in the coaching staff, a side that is going through a rebuilding phase, even with Joe Schmidt, who then admits that he probably knows the box better than his own team, which makes sense with him coaching against box when he was with Ireland and the box, All Blacks.
Yeah, well, the new coaching staff, a lot of changes have been done on their side. I think they've done very well by beating Wales twice. And I think they had four games on a trot now unbeaten, which is great for them. But I mean, I'm like us, they made a couple of changes. I think they got a new scrum coach in by Mike Cron. It's been a lot of experience guy coming from New Zealand, and he's been with World Rugby in the past. So they're doing very well at the moment. I think they got 100% of their scrum so far, as I said earlier. But like us, we made a couple of changes as well. And I can't say they're better prepared like in the past. I never looked down on the previous coach and said they were better prepared this time. But I can assure you, you can see there's a lot of progress going on their side, and they're playing a good brand of rugby.
Any further English questions? Can you so?
Thank you very much, Zina. Erchia, good evening, man. Just talk to me more about how different it is to play Australia now. That SA is not part of Super Rugby, as compared to when Australia were part of Super Rugby and there was a bit more familiarity with the players.
Yeah, I must say it's certainly different prepping against them with not having to face the guys throughout the season before. You know, it is a little bit different in that way. So, yeah, they'll just have to be a lot of extra work going into this week with, you know, watching player profiles and seeing who's going to play and studying up on guys and studying up on, you know, maybe some past games throughout the season, whereas previously we would have seen that.
Peter?
And just on you guys flying in earlier than normal, is that sort of a thing that the players, you guys chat about, and how do you feel about it? Do you feel it's better to do it that way than to come in the week of the test series?
Yeah, I definitely think it's beneficial to us because We get here earlier and we certainly get over that jet lag a little bit sooner, and it's not in the test week, you know, so we can have a full week of prep. And yeah, we're into things this side once test week hits.
Mubi?
Hi, Coach Dan, hope you guys are well. Coach Dan, the last time the Springboks actually beat the Wallabies in Brisbane was in 2013, 11 years ago. Have you guys spoken about sort of the Brisbane hoodoo and trying to you know, get the victory? Because it's a quite a tough venue for the Boks to win at.
Yeah, obviously we're aware of that record that they have against us, which is great for them. But I don't think none of us has been part of that team, the coaching staff, from that long ago. So yeah, it's history. Saturday's game will also be history coming Sunday. So it's just a fact. And all that I can tell you is we on our side, we just do everything to be well prepared to face them and maybe having a good game against them. And obviously, likewise, I think they're doing the same, exactly the same. So yeah, obviously coming Saturday, we know that we need to pitch up obviously physically and everything, having everything in place to be performant against them.
Guys, Nathan and Ben have asked questions. Are there any further English questions? Because then we can switch to Afrikaans. Okay, let's go. Ken, Nathan, Mubin, and then we'll switch to Afrikaans.
Thanks, Sina. Grant, for you, there seems to have been a lot of different scrum halves playing for Australia lately. Just what do you make of the scrum halves they have? And yeah, I guess what are you expecting on Saturday?
I think all three of them, they are experienced. I don't know which ones are going to play. If you look at Nick White, I think he's played more than 30 games for Australia already. Jake Gordon and Tate McDermott, I think, are really experienced scrum halves. I think they'll bring their part, calmness, experience, and yeah, I think that's what I can expect from Saturday.
Nathan and then Ken?
Thank you again, Zina. Coach Dawn, the players who didn't make the Australian leg, will they have to play in the Curry Cup for game time and to be match ready? A perfect example, Stephen Kitson just came back from injury, and Russell last week said that he needs game time, and the West Province coaching staff said they're still waiting on feedback from the bot camp regarding Kitson if he's to play in the Curry Cup. And secondly, will the players who weren't chosen, do they have to play in the Curry Cup for game time?
Yeah, well, how can I say, some of the players been left behind. So obviously, we can only take a squad of, I think, 33 here. And the fact that some guys had to stay behind, which is a good thing, actually, sometimes if you're staying behind and not making the starting lineup or the match 23, you can stay fit. And obviously, the rugby part, there's still 9 tests left for the rest of the season. So every test is very important for us. And the more a guy can play, the more match that he can get. I'm not referring to any players, but I think they themselves will benefit from that. So yeah, I hope it answers your question.
All right, guys, let's switch over to Afrikaans now. Please raise your hands for questions. Peter?
Thank you, Zee. Grant, net for you. As jy soort van besig om jou voete te vind nou met die meer speeltyd wat jy in die begintry kry. Hoe sien jy dit en hoe ervaar jy dit?
Ek dink met meer tyd, ek dink elke speler, ek dink erg jy kan saam my stem, dat dit maak jou bietjie beter en dit gee jou bietjie meer confidence of selfvertroue. So ek sal sê ek begin meer gemaklik raak met die type druk wat op 'n Saterdag kom, so ja.
En net wat verwag jy daarvan van Australië? Jy het nou lekker tyd gehad om in te settle, wat verwag jy daai kant? Ons mos maar altyd 'n moeilike reeks, as ek so kan sê, as 'n 2 toetse daai kant is teen hulle.
Ag, ek dink dit is 'n span wat met 3 wenne nou in 'n toetsweek gaan. Ek dink hulle selfvertroue gaan opwees. Ek dink dis 'n span wat met groot selfvertroue die game gaan speel die naweek. En ja, ons verwag maar dat dit taaf gaan wees, soos altyd.
Sorry, I don't know if I can continue, if it's fine, or is there someone else?
Litten, yeah, if no one else has any other questions, Litten, then you can fire away. That's perfect.
All right. RG, net vir jou asseblief, jy jy is besig om daai transisie te maak van bomb squad af na begins die beginspan toe. Net Grant het dit nou genoem, maar net in jou woorde, wat is daai gevoel om daai skuif te maak waar jy weet jy moet nou actually vir daai eerste 50 60 minute gaan speel?
Ja, ek dink dis obviously altyd lekker om bietjie meer game time te kry, maar die span is so goed rondom hulle, elkeen verstaan sy rol. So dit maak noodwendig altyd saak of jy begin of jy van die bank af speel nie, ons almal verstaan daai rol en jy verstaan hoe belangrik al twee van dit is. So ja, jy gryp maar elke geleentheid wat jy kry.
Lisa, ask one last question and then we'll have Supersport ask a couple of questions that are here, and then we can wrap up the news conference from there. So last question, Lipu.
Annie, ek so net RG wat jy van Australië se lynstaande verwag veral en dan ook om hoe jy ingeskuif het met die soort van nuwe wedstrydplan wat jy het daar by die Bokke.
Ja, Australië obviously ek kan mens sien uit paar van hulle lynstaande uit. Oor die vorige paar games dat hulle dalk 'n bietjie nuwe stelsel hardloop en so, maar ons verwag definitief 'n goeie tempo lynstaan van hulle kant af en ja, hulle het nogal klein detail in hulle lynstaan en goeie variasie rondom dit wat mense bietjie kan besig hou daar. So ons sal seker maak as ons goed geprep en ja, en net op die nuwe manier van hoe ons dinge doen en hoe ons speel is baie, dit maak jou eintlik opgewonde. Dit is lekker om bietjie jy weet, jou spel en dinge rondom die game op 'n ander manier te sien en om dit op 'n ander manier te ervaar en amper dit ter ander oë te sien en dan met bietjie met hom te hardloop ook is lekker.
Russell?
Ja, you played most of your tests making an impact off the bench, but there's more requirement for you to start with Franco out. How different is both the physical and the mental approach to starting?
Yeah, I think physically there's certainly a different way you prepare going into a game and on game day itself, but mentally nothing much has changed. I think myself and Franco and all the locks, actually we always sit together before the game and plan what we're going to do and how we're going to do things regarding the lineout throughout the game. So from that perspective, nothing much has changed.
The last time you played the Wallabies in Australia was a dominant win in Sydney after a disappointing loss in Adelaide. How much has been said about the importance of making a strong statement in the opening game to set the tone for the Rugby Championship?
Yeah, it is definitely important for us, especially playing Australia in Brisbane. I think, you know, it's the guys will definitely pitch up and it's going to be a tough game. But from our side, you know, we made sure we are early enough. We put in all the prep and all the work we can do and we'll make sure we go out on Saturday, yeah, with everything we have.
Okay, Don, come through to you now. Don, you travel slightly earlier than usual. How useful has it been as additional prep time being over the weekend to acclimatize properly?
I think it's quite very comfortable travel a little bit earlier, so you can have a little bit more time and jet lag and getting over the jet lag, which I haven't overcome yet because I went to bed this morning at 5:15. But anyway, apart from that, giving prep gives us basically two more days to prep as well. I think every little bit can help. So hopefully coming Saturday, we can look back and say, listen, it helped us a lot.
Coach in Afrikaans, if you can answer this in Afrikaans, what's the message from you as coach has been around the importance of making a strong statement in the opening round?
I think dit sal 'n ongelooflike goeie begin vir ons wees as ons kan begin om alles wat ons voorgewerk het in die laaste, sal ek sê, 5 weke deur die eerste toets en deur die eerste reeks om daarop te kan bou. Dink ons is 'n bietjie unlucky met een of twee goeters, maar ek dink ons werk om daai goeters vir ons te laat werk en hopelik as alles goed gaan, kan ons daarop bou. Natuurlik, ons het 'n baie sterk Australiese span wat ons moet face
en om dit reg te kry moet ons eers ons eie dinge in plek sit.
Ja. Rod, you got your second cap and first test win against Australia at Loftus. How different a team do you think they are now, and how much of a challenge do you think they will be at home?
I think, first of all, it was a whole different coaching staff. Last year, I think, when we played them at Loftus. And to play them here, I haven't played them in Australia yet, so I think that will be a different challenge. And like I said before, it's a team that just won 3 test matches and they'll be confident, so it will be a different beast.
Hoeveel inligting het julle oor die Australiese span soos wat julle dink hy sal nou wees as julle kyk na die squad wat hulle bymekaar gesit het?
Ek dink ons het 'n goeie idee van wie daar kan speel, wie moontlik beskikbaar sal wees vir hulle. Ek dink ons sal seker die finale antwoord het wanneer die span uitkom, maar ons het min of meer 'n idee van wie in die kamp is en wie kan speel moontlik vir hulle.
Awesome. That's me.
Guys, thank you very much. I'll be sending out the recording shortly.